Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, welcome to my channel. So in today's video, I'll be sharing a comparison between these two strobing cream. So this one is from Maybelline. This is Master Strobing Cream from Maybelline, and this is MAC Strobe Cream. So I'll be comparing these two strobing cream side by side in today's video, and I'll tell you how they perform and what is the difference and which one I feel is better. So if you are interested, please keep on watching this video. And if you are interested to know how I got this look which I am wearing today, check out the video on my Instagram. So you'll have to follow me on Instagram if you are not already following me. I'll mention my Instagram handle on the screen and in the description box, so you can check that. And if you are wondering what I'm wearing on my lips, I'm wearing this liquid lipstick from Physician Formula. It's in the shade Dose of Rose. So I'll be sharing the comparison between these strobing cream. This one is Maybelline Master Studio Strobing Cream, and this one is MAC Strobing Cream. So let's first talk about the packaging and pricing and all those things. So this is how this Maybelline strobing cream looks like. It comes in this kind of squeezy tube packaging. The strobing cream comes in this cardboard packaging where details are mentioned on back of it. It comes like this. So this strobing cream retails for 665 rupees for 18 ml of product, and the shelf life of this strobing cream is 3 years. Now let's talk about the MAC one. So this is how the MAC strobing cream looks like. It also comes in this squeezy tube packaging. This one is actually the mini version of it. It comes in the bigger version as well, but I have the mini version with me. So as far as I remember, it doesn't come in any kind of outer packaging, but I'm not sure. This strobing cream retails for 1090 rupees, and you get 30 ml of product in this. The shelf life of this strobing cream is 2.5 years. So the packaging wise, both the strobing cream looks very similar. Both of these comes in these kind of squeezy tube packaging. Maybelline one comes with this cap which you'll have to screw open. And here is the tube where you can squeeze this and get the product out of it. While in this MAC one, you get this kind of cap which you need to open, and then you can squeeze out the product from this tube. So both of these comes in squeezy tube packaging only, but the cap is different. If we compare these two strobing cream price-wise, dono ka hi price kafi similar hai. When you hear the prices for the first time, this retails for 665 rupees and this one is 1090. So you think ki this is cheaper than this, but aisa nahi hai, because you get only 18 ml of product in this one, while you are getting 30 ml of product in this one. So if you do the calculation, price jo hai wo dono ka kafi similar hai. And I think MAC one you get little cheaper than the Maybelline one, because you are getting more product in this one. Now let's talk about the texture of these strobing cream. So I have the Maybelline one here, and it looks like this. It is creamy and it has very small shimmer particle to it. I hope you can see that on the camera. There are shimmer particles in it. There are very tiny particles, but there are still shimmer particles in this strobing cream. Now let me show you the MAC one. So this is how the MAC one looks like. So this is how the MAC strobing cream looks like, and you don't see any kind of shimmer particles in this one, while you can clearly see shimmer particles in this one. So the texture wise, MAC strobing cream is more liquidy and creamier than the Maybelline one, and there are shimmer particles in Maybelline strobing cream, while you don't see any shimmer particles in MAC one. So the shimmers are more visible in Maybelline strobing cream than the MAC one, and when you apply the Maybelline one, you can actually see some shimmer particles on your hand as well. So the shimmers are more visible in the Maybelline one than the MAC one, and the Maybelline one is very thick and less creamier than the MAC one. If we talk about the shade range, the Maybelline strobing cream comes in two shades. One is pink and other one is nude. I have got the shade pink. The MAC strobing cream actually comes in 5 different shades, but in the bigger version of it, and in the smaller version which I have, it comes only in one shade, and I guess the shade is pink light. The shade is not mentioned here, but I think by looking at the color and all, I can see that the shade here is pink light. So I tried these strobing creams side by side on my face. So let's see that demo now, and then I will summarize this video for you guys. So first I will apply these strobing cream under my foundation. So I have already moisturized my face and applied the primer. So I'll apply this MAC strobing cream on right side of my face, and I'll use this strobing cream for Maybelline on this side, and we will see ki without any foundation ye kaise lagta hai skin ke upar. So first let's apply the Maybelline one. So I'm taking I took this much. I'll just dot it. I don't know how much we need because I have not tried the Maybelline one. I have tried the MAC one, but Maybelline one I have not tried. So I'm taking this much and then I'll just spread it all over the face. Since I took more, so I'm applying it. Otherwise, I don't think you need that much. So this is how this Maybelline Strobe Cream looks on bare skin. Now let's try the MAC one on this side. I'm not sure whether you can see or not, but you can see a little bit of shimmer on my hand from the application. I'll just remove it. So I'm taking the similar amount for this MAC one as well. So I'm taking this much and I'll apply. So this is how my skin looks after applying the MAC Strobe Cream. On this side I have Maybelline Strobe Cream and on this side I have MAC Strobe Cream. So both strobe creams are giving a very nice hydration and glow to the skin, but there is a difference. So on a Maybelline side, I can see, when I see closely, I can see a little bit of shimmer particles on this side. I don't think you can see from camera. Those shimmer particles are not visible from far, but if you look close, you can easily see that there are small shimmer particles on this side. But on this side where I applied MAC Strobe Cream, there are no shimmer particles. It's like a cream only, and it is giving a natural glow without any shimmer particles on this side. So this side looks more natural than this side. From the far, if you see, you won't be able to figure out the difference, but if you see closely, you can easily figure out the difference. I'm not sure whether you can see it, but on this side there are shimmer particles, while on this side there are no shimmer particles. So I'll do rest of my base makeup and then I will use these strobe creams as highlighter, and we will see how they perform as a highlighter. So I applied the foundation and I used this Maybelline Superstay foundation, which is a matte foundation. And you can see my face is not looking that matte because of the strobe cream which I have applied on both the sides. You can see there is still little bit of a glow left because of the strobe creams on both the sides actually. So both the sides are looking very similar now. There is no much difference you can see. I applied foundation and concealer. Now let's use these strobing creams as a highlighter. So I'll use this one on this side. So I'll apply this strobing cream on high points of my face. This time I'm taking very little. So it looks nice, but those shimmer particles are visible. Again, if you see closely, then only you will be able to see those shimmer particles. Otherwise, those are very tiny, so you can't see from afar. But up close, if you see, you can see those shimmer particles. So I've applied very less and it looks like this. Let me apply a little bit more. So this is how it looks after applying the second layer. You can see this shine here. Now let's apply the MAC one on this side. So I'm taking very little of this. So this is how this MAC Strobe Cream look when I applied this as a highlighter. For this side I have used the Maybelline Strobe Cream and on this side I have used the MAC one. You can see the difference. So I think this side looks better than this side. You can see a very nice glow and highlight here. While on this side, I don't see a much glow or shine. Also, one more thing which I noticed is that when I applied the MAC strobing cream on this side, since it's very creamy, it moved my foundation a little bit, which was not the case with the Maybelline one. It applied very nicely and didn't move the foundation at all. But on this side, I can see that foundation has been moved from its place a little bit because of the too creamy texture of this strobing cream, I guess. So that's the major difference which I see when I applied these strobing creams on top of the foundation. Let's talk about all the points one by one. First one is packaging. So both comes in similar kind of packaging. Both comes in squeezy tube packaging. Just that the way you need to take out the product is little different. The cap is a little different. Otherwise, both comes in same kind of packaging. The shade range, Maybelline has two shades in it and the MAC one has five shades. But in the mini version, there is only one shade available, which is pink. Third is the price. So the Maybelline one retails for 665 rupees, but you get 18 ml of product there, while in MAC one you get 30 ml of product for 1090 rupees. So the price wise both are similar, and actually you are getting more product in a MAC one. Fourth is the texture. The MAC one is more creamier and liquidy than the Maybelline one. Maybelline strobing cream is little thick and that has shimmer particles, visible shimmer particles to that, while the Maybelline one doesn't have those much visible shimmer particles. Fifth, the application of both the strobing cream is actually easy. It's very easy to blend the strobing creams on the face, as you saw in the demo. Both side the blending was very easy. When I applied these strobing creams on my bare face, the Maybelline one was looking more shimmery, while the MAC one was looking more natural because the shimmer particles in Maybelline one is more visible. So this part of my face was not looking that natural, while this part of my face was looking very natural because the shimmers were not visible on MAC one. Next, how they perform as a highlighter. So I used Maybelline one on this side and MAC one on this side. So Maybelline strobing cream performs better as a highlighter because when I applied the MAC strobing cream on this side, it moved my foundation because it's very creamy. So it moved my foundation and it was not that visible. It was not giving that kind of glow which you want from your highlighter, while the Maybelline one didn't move the foundation and it was looking actually better as a highlighter. Now, to summarize this video, price wise and packaging wise, both the strobing creams are same. Maybelline one has more shimmer particles to it, while the MAC one looks very natural. So it depends ki aap kis purpose ke liye strobing cream ko purchase kar rahe hain. If you want to use this strobing cream under your foundation to get a very natural glow on your face, I would recommend you guys to go for a MAC one because that gives a very natural glow to your face and it doesn't have those visible and it doesn't have visible shimmer particles to it. So it will give you a natural glow and you can use that strobing cream under your foundation. But if you want to use this strobing cream as a highlighter, I won't recommend you guys to go with MAC one because it doesn't perform good on top of the foundation. So go for the Maybelline one because it has more shimmery particles to it. It will look good. It will give you a highlighter like glow and it won't move your foundation. So it will be very easy to apply it on top of your foundation. So both the strobing creams are good, but it depends on for what purpose you are purchasing this strobing cream. So yeah, that's all for today's video. I hope you liked this comparison video and it was helpful for you. If you did, please like and share this video. Also, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already. And don't forget to press the notification bell so that you will be notified for my future uploads. If you want me to do a comparison video on any other product, please let me know in the comment box. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. I'll see you in my next one. Till then, take care. Bye.